Hello, I'm Reva. Today, I'll be talking about developing learning outcomes. What are learning outcomes? First of all, let us try and understand what exactly do we mean by these learning outcomes. Learning outcomes are statements that describe the knowledge or skills students should acquire by the end of a particular assignment, class, course, or program, and help students understand why that knowledge and those skills will be useful to them. They focus on the context and potential applications of knowledge and skills, help students connect learning in various contexts, and help guide assessment and evaluation. Good learning outcomes emphasize the application and integration of knowledge. Instead of focusing on coverage of material, learning outcomes articulate how students will be able to employ the material, both in the context of the class and more broadly. Let us look at some of the examples of learning outcomes. By the end of this course, students will be able to predict the appearance and motion of visible celestial objects, formulate scientific questions about the motion of visible celestial objects, plan ways to model and/or simulate an answer to the questions chosen, select and integrate information from various sources, including electronic and print resources, community resources, and personally collected data to answer the questions chosen. Communicate scientific ideas, procedures, results, and conclusions using appropriate SI units, language, and formats. Why develop learning outcomes? Learning outcomes are valuable to learners, instructors, and administrators. Learning outcomes are more than simply several sentences appended to existing lesson plans or curricula. Instead, the development of learning outcomes and their use within a unit of instruction shapes learning and assessment activities and can enhance student engagement and learning. Because of their ability to benefit many groups in post-secondary education, the development of learning outcomes has become an increasing priority for instructors and institutions over the course of the last decade. Establishing a focus on integrated, generalizable, and transferable skills complements contemporary demands on graduates and builds a foundation for lifelong learning. As government and public attention on the products of higher education increases, learning outcomes help to define the goals and essential aspects of higher education within the institution to students and to the general public. What are the various tools for developing learning outcomes? Let us have a look at that. Learning outcomes should outline the most central and essential elements of a particular course or program. They will also shape assessment. As such, the process of developing learning outcomes offers an opportunity for reflection on what is most necessary to help learners gain this knowledge and these skills. Considering keywords for the course, desired types of learning, and the context in which the knowledge and skills gained in the course will be used, including possible applications, provides a foundation for the development of learning outcomes. So let us see how language is important while developing or framing these learning outcomes. Articulating your outcomes. To begin the process of developing learning outcomes, it may be useful to brainstorm some keywords central to the disciplinary content and generalizable skills taught in the course. In addition to the information about context and types of learning, you may wish to consider some of the questions as you develop this list of keywords, such as: what are the essential things students must know to be able to succeed in the course? What are the essential things students must be able to do to succeed in the course? What knowledge or skills do students bring to the course that the course will build on? What knowledge or skills will be new to the students in the course? What other areas of knowledge are connected to the work of the course? Educational objectives, addressing levels of learning. Scholars working in pedagogy and epistemology offer us taxonomies of learning that can help make learning outcomes more precise. These levels of learning can also help develop assessment and evaluation methods appropriate to the learning outcomes for the course. Let us see how Bloom's taxonomy helps us in understanding these educational objectives and also in development of these educational objectives. Bloom's taxonomy of educational objectives is particularly useful because it associates particular verbs with each level of learning. Although Bloom's taxonomy is a hierarchy, each type of learning can be a valuable aspect of a course. Ultimately, however, learning outcomes should focus on the higher order thinking found in the highest levels of the taxonomy, that is, analyze, evaluate, and create. Bloom's taxonomy was developed in 1956 and was revised in 2001 by Bloom's colleagues Lauren Anderson and David Krathwohl. The revised taxonomy can be understood using the table, such as remember, understand, apply, analyze, evaluate, and create. And the next column shows the most relevant and useful verbs that have been listed against each level of learning. Content, skills, and values. What is the importance of these three words in development of learning outcomes? These three areas can be used to identify and describe different aspects of learning that might take place in a course. Content can be used to describe the disciplinary information covered in the course. This content might be vital to future work or learning in the area. Skills can refer to the disciplinary or generalizable skills that students should be able to employ by the conclusion of the class. Some learning outcomes might articulate desired values, attitudes, or beliefs that are imparted or investigated in the course of learning in a field or discipline. In particular, value-oriented learning outcomes might focus on ways that knowledge or skills gained in the course will enrich students' experiences throughout their lives. Context. Let us try and see what is the importance of this word in framing learning outcomes. Learning outcomes help instructors and learners focus on the potential applications of the knowledge and skills gained in the course. In turn, this helps students perceive the value of their learning and helps instructors develop appropriate assessment tools. Let us now try and understand the characteristics of good learning outcomes. Good learning outcomes focus on the application and integration of the knowledge and skills acquired in a particular unit of instruction, for example, activity, course program, etc., and emerge from a process of reflection on the essential content of a course. More specifically, good learning outcomes should be very specific and use active language and verbs in particular that make expectations clear. This informs students of the standards by which they will be assessed and ensures that student and instructor goals in the course are aligned. For example, let us have a look at the slide. The slide has two columns and the titles of the two columns are vague outcome and more precise outcome. Let us compare the two types of learning outcomes. By the end of the course, I expect students to increase their organization, writing, and presentation skills. Now, let us see what is the more precise form of the same learning outcome. By the end of the course, students will be able to produce professional quality writing, communicate the results of their research findings, and analyze to fellow classmates in an oral presentation. The vague learning outcome. By the end of this course, students will be able to use secondary critical material effectively and to think independently. This is vague because there is no action verb used and the learning outcome framed is not written in behavioral terms. Let us look at the more precise form of the same learning outcome. By the end of this course, students will be able to evaluate the theoretical and methodological foundations of secondary critical material and employ this evaluation to defend their position on the topic. Evaluate and employ the two action verbs having been used, which makes the learning outcome more precise and clear. Secondly, learning outcomes should be flexible. What do we mean by that? While individual outcomes should be specific, instructors should feel comfortable adding, removing, or adjusting learning outcomes over the length of a course if initial outcomes prove to be inadequate. Learning outcomes should be focused on the learner. Rather than explaining what the instructor will do in the course, good learning outcomes describe knowledge or skills that the student will employ and help the learner understand why that knowledge and those skills are useful and valuable to their personal, professional, and academic future. Learning outcomes should be realistic, not aspirational. All passing students should be able to demonstrate the knowledge or skill described by the learning outcome at the conclusion of the course. In this way, learning outcomes established standards for the course. Learning outcomes should focus on the application and integration of acquired knowledge and skills. Good learning outcomes reflect and indicate the ways in which the described knowledge and skills may be used by the learner now and in the future. Learning outcomes indicate useful modes of assessment and the specific elements that will be assessed. Good learning outcomes prepare students for assessment and help them feel engaged in and empowered by the assessment and evaluation process. And a good learning outcome offers a timeline for completion of the desired learning. This table will help you in understanding it better. When writing your outcomes, keep in mind learning outcomes should be SMART. What exactly do we mean? The table has two columns. Look at the first column. Speak to the learner. What does it mean? Learning outcomes should address what the learner will know or be able to do at the completion of the course. Learning outcomes should be measurable, which means learning outcomes must indicate how learning will be assessed. Third, it should be applicable. Learning outcomes should emphasize ways in which the learner is likely to use the knowledge or skills gained. Next, realistic. All learners who complete the activity or course satisfactorily should be able to demonstrate the knowledge or skills addressed in the outcome. Next, the learning outcome should be time-bound. The learning outcome should set a deadline by which the knowledge or skills should be acquired. Learning outcomes should be transparent. That means they should be easily understood by the learner. They should be transferable, which means they should address knowledge and skills that will be used by the learner in a wide variety of contexts. Assessment following through on learning outcomes. Let us try and understand what do we mean by this. Through assessment, learning outcomes can become fully integrated in course design and delivery. Because learning outcomes focus on the application and integration of knowledge and skills learned, they point to appropriate modes of assessment and ensure that assessment focuses on the essential knowledge or skills of the course. Assignments and examinations should match the knowledge and skills described in the course's learning outcomes. A good learning outcome can readily be translated into an assignment or examination question. If it cannot, the learning outcome may need to be refined. One way to match outcomes with appropriate modes of assessment is to return to Bloom's taxonomy of educational objectives. The verbs associated with each level of learning indicate the complexity of the knowledge or skills that students should be asked to demonstrate in an assignment or exam question. An outcome, for example, that asks students to recall key moments leading up to an historical event might be assessed through multiple choice or short answer questions. By contrast, an outcome that asks students to evaluate several different policy models might be assessed through a debate or written test. Thus, through assessment, learning outcomes can become fully integrated in course design and delivery. Learning outcomes may also point to more unconventional modes of assessment. Because learning outcomes can connect student learning with its application both within and outside of an academic context, learning outcomes may point to modes of assessment that parallel the type of work that students may produce with the learned knowledge and skills in their career or later in life. The worksheet, which we would be presenting soon, might help you translate your instructional goals or objectives for a unit of instruction into an accessible learning outcome. Remember that each unit of instruction might have multiple learning outcomes. This is the table. It has five columns. Let us have a look at the title of these columns. The first one talks about the unit of instruction. This is something that you would be teaching. The objective, what is the purpose? What content or skills will be covered in this instruction. The third is outcome, that is the learning outcome. What should students know or be able to do as a result of this unit of instruction? The next one is about how do you know? How will you be able to tell that students have achieved this outcome? And the last one is about assessment. What kind of work can students produce to demonstrate this? We will now try to understand the connection of course, program, and institution with the framing of learning outcomes. Learning outcomes can also be implemented at the program or institutional level to assess student learning over multiple courses and to monitor whether students have acquired the necessary knowledge and skills at one stage to be able to move on to the next. Series of courses. What is the connection here? Courses that require prerequisites may benefit from identifying a list of outcomes necessary for advancement from one level to another. When this knowledge and these skills are identified as outcomes as opposed to topics, assessment in the first level can directly measure preparation for the next level. Program. How is this connected? Many major and specialist programs identify a list of discipline-specific and multipurpose skills, values, and areas of knowledge graduating students in the program will have. By articulating these as things that students will know or be able to do, the benefits of a program of study can be clearly communicated to prospective students, to employers, and to others in the institution. To understand this, let us have an example. Learning outcomes for BA Anthropology program may include knowledge outcomes, such as a result of completing this program, students should be able to show evidence of a broad understanding of the past and present social, linguistic, and cultural diversity of people and their biological diversity and evolution. Show familiarity with the nature of the four fundamental fields within anthropology, that is archaeology, biological anthropology, anthropological linguistics, and cultural anthropology, and their interrelationship. This familiarity will lead students to adopt a holistic and comparative approach to understanding human differences and similarities across the world and through time. Demonstrate a familiarity with basic anthropological concepts, terminology, and theory. This familiarity will lead students to an appreciation of anthropology's history and context. The application of anthropology to other discussions will become a part of students' general liberal arts and science university degree. Skills outcomes. What is the connect here? As a result of completing this program, students should be able to show evidence of a familiarity with anthropological research methods, critically analyze their use in the research of other research methods, demonstrate a facility in critical thinking and reasoning by applying these skills to anthropological problems and issues, exhibit university-level skills in academic writing, including research and argumentation, apply their academic writing skills to anthropological problems and issues. Value outcomes. Let us see how these are framed. As a result of completing this program, students should be able to demonstrate a fundamental awareness of the cultural and social basis of human prejudice and discrimination, for example, racism, ethnocentrism, sexism, anthropocentrism, and anthropological insights and alternatives that foster tolerance for the diversity of human cultures, ways of life, and the value of human diversity. Let us see how institution is connected to framing of learning outcomes. Academic plans increasingly include a list of learning outcomes that apply across programs of study and even across degree levels. These outcomes provide an academic vision for the institution, serve as guidelines for new programs and programs undergoing review, and communicate to members of the university and the public at large the academic values and goals of the university. As already discussed, the best learning outcomes address course-specific learning within the context of a student's broader educational experience. One way to contribute to a coherent learning experience is to align course outcomes with institutional priorities. Thus, universities outline institutional goals in relation to the learning experience of their undergraduate and graduate students. These institutional goals clearly mention that undergraduate students should leave the university having acquired certain abilities, values, and commitments, such as ability to reason inductively and deductively, to analyze and to synthesize, to think through moral and ethical issues, to construct a logical argument with appropriate evidence, ability to communicate clearly, substantively, and persuasively, both orally and in writing. Ability not only to answer questions through research and analysis, but to exercise judgment about which questions are worth asking. Ability to be committed to standards of intellectual honesty and use of information. Ability to authenticate information, whether it comes from print sources or through new technologies. Ability to collaborate with others from different disciplines in the recognition that multidisciplinary approaches are necessary to address the major issues facing society. Ability to use the methods of scientific inquiry, that is, be scientifically literate. Curriculum mapping, translating between local global learning outcomes. Now, let us try and understand what exactly do we mean by this curriculum mapping. Curriculum mapping involves identifying which courses, portions of courses, or series of courses fulfill each programmatic or institutional learning outcome. The global learning outcomes can then be matched with course-specific outcomes that directly address the content and skills required for that particular subject material. Identifying and locating all the learning outcomes encountered by a student over the course of their program can help present learning as a coherent whole to students and others, and can help students make the connection between their learning in one course and that in another. A map reveals the multiple opportunities that students have to make progress on collectively agreed on learning goals, beginning with their first day on campus. Accompanied by a list of learning outcomes, maps can encourage students to take responsibility for their education as a process of integration and application, not as a checklist of courses and educational opportunities. Maps can also position students to make choices about courses and educational experiences that will contribute to their learning and improve areas of weakness. Useful verbs for developing learning outcomes. Now, this is very important. Let us try and have a look at these. The given list of useful verbs for creating learning outcomes is arranged according to Bloom's taxonomy of educational objectives, which identifies different cognitive domains associated with levels of learning. Bloom's taxonomy was developed in 1956 and was revised in 2001 by Bloom's colleagues Lauren Anderson and David Krafwall. The revised taxonomy is presented in the given slides, which will help you in understanding this taxonomy and thus will help you in development of learning outcomes. So to conclude, I'm sure that today's talk will help you in framing good learning outcomes, making use of action verbs, and framing them in students' behavioral terms. Thank you.